Now, when Red Dead Redemption 2 was announced all the way back in 2016, I said this was going to be one of my big concerns with this title. All the way back in 2016 and 2017, many had a feeling that Red Dead Redemption 2 would be online focused, the story mode may include some sort of microtransactions, and the online mode would feel very similar to Grand Theft Auto Online. So obviously, only one of those things are kinda true, as this game's story mode was quite clearly the focus, and there's no microtransactions within that, but in many ways, Red Dead Online feels like Grand Theft Auto Online. Specifically, the grind is something that is seriously a problem, and almost everything within this online mode costs money and has just abysmal prices. Obviously, this is just the beta, and Rockstar certainly is accepting feedback, something that they've made known, although I'm kinda surprised they haven't at all acknowledged the biggest issue that majority of players are complaining about. Also, let's be honest here, I'm not quite sure what the hell a beta is anymore, as both Rockstar Games and Bethesda Game Studios have recently tried using that term to describe the beginning of their online experiences, although by definition, these technically aren't really betas. Anyway, I've probably played somewhere around 20 hours of Red Dead Online so far, and I personally have had an okay time. I'll elaborate on that a little bit later, but I definitely feel there is a griefing issue, and gunplay feels much more clunky in the online mode, but I like the fact that there is a short story experience that you can do together with friends that can be impacted by honorable or dishonorable decisions. I wouldn't say it's the greatest story, but it's something to do and really the only rewarding aspect of the online experience right now. I also really dig some of the stranger missions that feature some surprise character returns, although most of those missions feel like fetch quests and can get quite repetitive and boring fast. The online game modes like Red Dead's version of Free For All and its own Battle Royale mode are pretty solid in my opinion. Although I wish we could actually just pick which type of game mode we wish to play, as just to play my first Battle Royale match, it took a few dozen games and I only found out it existed when other outlets like IGN talked about the mode. Also, hopefully in the future there will be options to play matches with specifically auto aim on or off. Now, free roam overall can be a really fun time with friends, as the lasso may actually be one of the best and worst things to be featured in Red Dead Online, but the biggest issue plaguing Red Dead Online is the economy, which just at this point is a joke. Everything, and I mean everything, costs something, and if you compare the prices from single player to the online, it really is interesting some of the choices Rockstar Games made. Like, one good example is I was completing a stranger mission, and I defeated numerous enemies and went to loot their bodies. What I got in return was about 8 to 10 cents, and maybe, just maybe, snake oil or bourbon. Then once I finished this actual stranger mission, which took about 10 to 12 minutes to complete, I earned 0.01 nuggets of gold and $2 and some change in actual game money. That for the most part is the story of Red Dead Online's economy, which is a serious problem right now. Even in a match of Free For All, which likely is some of the gameplay in the background, this was one of my better games and I earned 0.02 nuggets of gold and $12 and some change, but that again was about 10 minutes of gameplay. The most rewarding part of Red Dead Online so far is the 6-part story, which you earn, I believe, in total about 1 gold bar and a few hundred dollars, but this is really the only thing that you can earn big money from right now. So the thing is, the rewarding in Red Dead Online would not be a problem if everything didn't cost a ridiculous amount. But before we get to these costs, let me show a Reddit post which has gone viral, outlining how broken the economy is. Reddit user UnavailableID stated, "I played around 4 hours yesterday. You need to get 1.00 nuggets to do 1 gold bar. You get in between 0.02 to 0.04 from series matches, which is racing, deathmatches, battle royale, free for all, etc. And these all take around 10 minutes of time. Assuming you always get 0.02 and there's no loading time, it takes 50 games, 500 minutes to get 1 gold bar. That makes 8 hours and 20 minutes, and that's assuming you get the worst nugget reward and you always reach time limit." The thing is, this math is pretty accurate, and when I'm grinding in any game, I always ask myself, am I having fun? With games like Call of Duty Black Ops 1 years ago, I was having tons of fun because I felt like I was being properly rewarded as I played and as I ranked up. More recently, with Fallout 76, I was not having fun, and with Red Dead Online right now, I'm losing the interest. The lack of being able to rob banks or stores, no poker, no bounties, no train robberies as far as I know in free roam, and really the lack of interesting things to do is what's holding back this online experience. experience in my opinion. But now, let's get to these prizes. So I went to various different stores and places to show you how bad the economy is right now. Keep in mind the stats I went over earlier, with you earning, let's say, at best, 0.20 nuggets of gold and $70 in 1 hour of gameplay. That's definitely a little high, but let's just go off of that. Checking first with our own personal camp to actually change the theme of the camp, there are only a few options. The standard is what everyone gets, and the survivor came with the ultimate edition of Red Dead Redemption 2. The other ones are locked right now except for one, which cost $150, which based on normal gameplay and rewards right now, that's a couple hours of gameplay. Now as we proceed, the tents are based on rank, and even as you level up, they come with a steep cost. Just to change your flag color costs $50, and something I believe should be unlocked from the start, a fast travel post, is something that will take a long time to reach, and it certainly will come with some sort of cost. Now your camp's personal assistant of sorts, you can also upgrade his look, but again, the prices are steep, going from about $80 to over $130. And then we get our first look at the premium currency of gold. Some cosmetic items are specifically locked behind the gold, which in 20 hours of gameplay I've only earned around 1.5. But to unlock this outfit for Crips, it costs 10 gold bars, which means you will need to cough up money or do some insane grinding. Right now, the ability to spend real world money is not available, but it certainly is coming, and it'll be interesting to see what the prices are. Now, let's continue forward. Next stop is the barbershop, which even this comes with some crazy costs. In the single player, to get a haircut or change up the style of your hair costs just a few dollars at most. Even at the camp, you could give yourself a shave for free, but here it costs from $7 to $25. And the important thing to note about all of this, it adds up. There are some additional options here in the barber, like hair color and style, with some of them costing a gold bar. To the gun store, this is where prices really take off, first with customization options of a weapon like the volcanic pistol. To change the colors, it costs multiple gold bars, and the better the metal, the more costly it is, and engravings can cost over $100. To improve the actual weapon with changing the barrel, grip, or sights, or even the stock, this will cost another $50 each, although the better the weapon, the higher the cost for improving it. Now to the actual weapon prices, you obviously will need to rank up first, but after that, for the Litchfield repeater, that'll cost $580, which in the single player, it only costs $145. The rolling block rifle costs $685, which in the single player, it costs $187. And the most expensive item right now is the Mauser pistol, which costs $1,000, but in the single player, it was a fourth of the cost, sitting at $250. Another important note is that many of these weapons can be purchased with gold. The cost seems to be around 15 to 30 gold bars, which for any casual player will be unachievable unless they use real world money. Also at the gun store, there are some more cosmetics that can be purchased, like a gun belt or holsters. Costs for that range from about $7 to $50, and some of them can only be purchased with gold. So besides the gun store, barber, and your camp, there's also the general store, where you can buy food, medicine, and ammunition for your horse and yourself. There's also a bunch of outfits that you can purchase, many costing hundreds of dollars, and some again being locked behind a lot of gold. The same goes for individual pieces of clothing. We also have the stables, where you can buy horses, and well, the better the horse, the more expensive the cost. Interestingly though, multi-horses cost close to $1,000, or about 15 gold bars, and the best horse, the Arabian, cost $850, or 42 gold bars. Also, to have more than one horse, that'll cost $100, and the price only rises. The last thing I can think of is abilities, which to upgrade that, it'll cost about $50, and I think you guys see the problem. Most players won't be playing Red Dead Online for 10 hours a day, and many of these things cost ridiculous amounts of money, although there is a shortcut, which is gold bars. Although even then, ranking up is not something that's very fast. I don't know who at Rockstar thought these prices were fair, but they are not, and I keep remembering Rockstar Games is owned by Take-Two Interactive, who also owns the game franchise NBA 2K, who last year was infamous for making everything in the game cost ridiculous amounts of money. I also recall Take-Two Interactive preaching microtransactions as being the way of the future. And additionally, Take-Two CEO Strauss Zelnick's ballsy claim that they've under-monetized their players. So far, much of the Red Dead Online experience screams greed. And look, if these prices stay how they are right now, people will abandon this fast. There are already many other issues like missing features, bugs, and a lack of content hurting this online, and I get this is a beta of sorts, but I personally don't see a drive to grind right now. Besides matches and mission rewards, you can also go hunting and fishing, although even then the prices for that is very low and time consuming. Also, what I find very strange is that jewelry in Red Dead Online are practically worthless, with canned food being worth more. In the past, I've complained about Electronic Arts' pathetic loot boxes in Star Wars Battlefront 2, and more recently the absurd pricing in Fallout 76's Atomic Shop, but I definitely think right now you could make a case that Red Dead Online has one of the most egregious monetization schemes that I find unacceptable. There certainly is still time for this to change as the store is not up yet, but if that store goes live and the prices are close to how they are right now, I think this will be Rockstar shooting themselves in their foot, and creating a massive controversy as I guarantee the gaming community will revolt and turn on them. I love Rockstar games, but I've never been a fan of Grand Theft Auto Online, the pricing with that game, and so far I really don't know how long I will stick with Red Dead Online because it seems to be more of the same. Hopefully things improve, but as it stands, the economy is just a disaster. There's very little interesting things to do, and the good parts are few and far between. Still though, this has the potential to be really fun, although I have serious doubts that without some massive content updates, Red Dead Online will not have nearly the success Grand Theft Auto Online has had, and I really hope that Rockstar is not including these mediocre narrative elements in Red Dead Online to make up for not including single-player DLC later on, because I believe if Red Dead Redemption 2 does not get that, then the days of Rockstar single-player DLC is over, which will be a shame as there's so many cool avenues they could go with that. But yeah, these are just my thoughts right now. After the phenomenal single-player mode, this online feels kind of underwhelming, and I can only hope that Rockstar is listening and does the right thing, because if they don't, the gaming community will turn on them quick, just like with what's currently happening with Bethesda Game Studios. Anyway, what do you guys make of Red Dead Online so far? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below, but thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like if you did enjoy this video or found any informative value, and consider subscribing for much more Red Dead Online content to come. And remember, outlaws to the end.